Moderna's plans to set up a facility in the Philippines, its first in Asia, was one of the banner investment deals during President Marcos's U.S. trip. We got a chance to sit down with General Manager Patrick Bergstedt, who was recently in Manila to get the ball rolling. Here's that interview. Hi, Patrick. Thank you so much for joining us. Welcome to Market Edge.
Thank you very much for inviting me to join your program, Mimi. It's a pleasure to be here.
All right. So it's all systems go for your facility here in the Philippines?
Absolutely. We are moving at speed, and we hope to have this new facility operational in the third quarter by September.
Mm-hmm. I imagine you had a lot of meetings here so far. What's the sense that you're getting for this investment in the country, your first?
So as you're probably aware, Moderna met with the president during his visit in Washington. Mm-hmm. And he has opened many doors for us with various stakeholders. We've met with a number of authorities, and the reception that we're receiving is fantastic, and we are excited and energized to be here.
All right. Just to clarify, Patrick, you're building a shared service facility for pharmacovigilance in the Philippines, correct?
Mimi, it's even beyond that. So pharmacovigilance is a very key component because obviously it's important to monitor the safety and the tolerability of the vaccines that are available in the Philippines. But beyond that, there will also be financial services, human resource services, regulatory services, as well as IT services. So this is a service center that's providing solutions and services to support our business across the entire region. This facility is only one of three that we have in the world. Moderna went through a real due diligence looking at many, many other countries which are in competition with what is established business in the Philippines. But after having gone through that process and knowing the talents, the work ethic, and the quality of people that we can recruit in the Philippines, we selected the Philippines after that process.
Mm-hmm. I wonder, is it the cost here that's lower, the cost of labor that's cheap?
No, it's the quality of the people, mm-hmm. right? And the fact that you have a number of beautiful islands, but put that aside. No, it's really the quality of the talent that we have, and the fact that your shared services business is a very established mm-hmm. business, been at it for a number of years, and you've achieved a very, very high quality.
Mm-hmm. So two things. The shared services, it's pretty much like outsourcing the IT BPM, which is very strong here in the Philippines. We know that. Pharmacovigilance, for those who are not too aware, this is when you assess and you study potential side effects of vaccines, essentially clinical trials, right?
Correct. It's the monitoring the safety and the tolerability of vaccines. We take that very, very seriously, and that's why we are establishing that. And we'll work obviously with the Department of Health as well as other clinicians in the Philippines to ensure that the vaccines are safe.
All right. You did say that this is the third such facility. You've got one in Georgia, US, one in Poland. And I looked at Poland, one of the largest clinical trial markets in Central Europe. Is this the track for the Philippines as well, to be your next big clinical trial market?
Well, you may not know, your viewers may not know, that we've already have clinical trials that are ongoing in the Philippines. There were over 1,300 subjects enrolled in our influenza vaccine study. So mm-hmm. we're up and running, and we see the possibility of expanding beyond that. Because as you probably know, Mimi, COVID is one thing, but Moderna is not a COVID-19 company. We have a number of different vaccines for respiratory diseases. We also have vaccines for rare diseases, latent viruses, for example, cytomegalovirus, and we are also exploring mRNA for oncology. So there is the possibility that our entire portfolio comes to the Philippines over a period of time.
All right. And are there plans to eventually bring R&D, for example, and manufacture those vaccines here?
This facility that we are establishing, which I mentioned, this first phase is probably going to enroll about 40 to 50 people mm-hmm. by the end of 2023. But think about that as the first phase. We are modeling what we are building here in the Philippines, very similar to Poland and Georgia, as you mentioned. The Poland site now has over 200 people. So in phases, we will continue to expand and expand the contribution that Moderna makes to the Philippines as well as to the region.
Mm-hmm. So this will mean technology transfer, information transfer, powerful things that Filipino talent will be able to inherit from this investment.
Absolutely. We've already had discussions with the NIH, mm-hmm. as well as the Department of Health, as well as other stakeholders, which is how do we contribute to science, but also how do we understand how diseases and infections evolve? Mimi, as you know, the Asia region is a region that has seen many pandemics over time. You've seen H1N1, you've seen SARS, you've seen MERS in some countries, and now you see COVID. One thing that we can be certain of is that this COVID pandemic is not the last pandemic that we've seen. And one of Moderna's missions is to ensure pandemic readiness, health security through vaccines, work in close collaboration with the government to ensure that Filipinos are well protected for the future. So that is the power of us being here, embedded in the country, but close to stakeholders and authorities who are very committed on the health of the population in the Philippines.
Mm-hmm. Patrick, you did mention this. Moderna is not a COVID-19 company. You've got a very rich pipeline. I just wanted to ask, you mentioned a few of them already, but what are some of the promising initiatives in the pipeline? I know you're working on a personalized cancer vaccine, RSV data, combo virus vaccines. Could you walk us through very quickly your next big shots?
Let me start firstly with COVID, because I know that the WHO has sort of made certain declarations. I would say to Filipinos, let's not fall into false sense of security, because the virus, the COVID-2 virus, is continuing to circulate, is continuing to mutate. The virus that's circulating today, and I know that there's been a little bit of an uptick in infections in the Philippines, is not the same virus that caused the pandemic 2 years ago. So therefore, the vaccine needs to be updated. And Moderna's first commitment is that we will continue to keep the COVID-19 vaccine updated, relevant, so they can have the best protection for Filipinos. That's point number one. Second point is that respiratory diseases still cause a huge amount of morbidity, hospitalization. In some cases, if you're a very fragile person, unfortunately, death. We're looking at influenza, we're looking at RSV, but more interestingly, Mimi, is to develop a combination vaccine where an individual can receive one shot that provides broad protection across from a number of different diseases. Think about it like infant vaccines. Children receive combination vaccines, they've received combination vaccines for decades, but adults still need to receive mono vaccines. We want to change that completely. We want to be able to provide one vaccine that provides broad protection across a number of different viral diseases. Mm-hmm. So we're excited about that. Secondly, what I mentioned about latent viruses, these are viruses which are dormant, but they flare up. For example, cytomegalovirus, as well as Epstein-Barr virus. We are working on those. We have programs in early stage. We are also working, as you mentioned, on individualized cancer vaccines. Mm-hmm. This means taking the tumor of an individual, isolating the gene sequence, and then making a very targeted vaccine therapy specifically against that tumor type. That's the power of mRNA. And then we are also looking at rare diseases, being able to take mRNA, which, as you know, is an informational molecule. It provides the body with the instructions for how to make protein to either protect or treat against disease. And that's what we are very excited about for the future.
Exciting indeed, when you talk about these giant leaps that science and you guys are making, and even more exciting, the role that the Philippines will play in this a great leap. Thank you so much, Patrick, for joining us. We look forward to having the facility actually up and running by third quarter of this year.
Mimi, thank you very much for the invitation. Lovely to meet you, and it's been a pleasure. All the best to you.
All right.